Hey, Julie Roussel here. Hey, welcome to Wacky Wednesday. Or you never know what the topic's going to be. And no, I'm definitely not running on time tonight, not anywhere close. We had our first home opener for volleyball for my son's 7th grade team, and things ran really later than expected. So of course I'm, running later than expected. But as always, if you welcome to Wacky Wednesday, I appreciate you joining in, whether you are popping in live right now or you are catching on the replay. I'm glad that you could join in for a little bit of kitchen conversation. As always, if you hear something that resonates with you or that you find valuable, leave me a little bit of love. Answer the question in the thread. Feel free to drop your thoughts and comments there as well. Share the video with anyone you think it might help and PM me if you have questions or just want to hear a little bit more. I'm always happy to share the things that I'm learning, and I really hope that they benefit you. So, hey, welcome, friends. I see a few joining in. I must be lagging behind or I'm missing you. I apologize for that. But hey, welcome. I appreciate you joining in. And I'm seeing people join in, but I'm not seeing who it is at this time. So I apologize for not welcoming you right away. Just do me a favor and leave me a hey and let me know that you popped in. Or if you're leaving me a hey, happy St. Patty's Day. I would appreciate that. And I hope that you like some fun headgear. And I hope that you have some fun headgear as well. So who am I see? Like I said, I still see you. I'm gonna go on and hopefully when you pop up on the screen, I will welcome you. So tonight, as always, I want to share a short story, what I learned, and hopefully how it can benefit you. Oh, hey, thanks for the love. I totally messed it. I'm sorry. I'll admit it. I was peeking at my notes. I'm sorry, friends. But thank you for the love. It is very much appreciated. But like I said, tonight I wanted to share a short story, what I learned, and hopefully how it can benefit you. And I'll be honest, I was not very prepared. Oh, there you are. Hey, Amber. Great to see you, lady. Hey, thank you. I appreciate that. I'm glad you like my headgear. But like I said, tonight I was not very prepared. I lost my notes earlier this week and I've been searching for them and had a whole video prepared and, nothing. So I had to come up with something from scratch last minute. And I was kind of rushed, down to the wire because I only had about a half hour. But like I said, I'm not very prepared tonight, but thankfully I was able to get a few thoughts and a few notes down to peek at because, I need them. Thank you. I appreciate that. And the question for the night: should you celebrate the small things, the small victories? And I'd appreciate if you leave an answer in there. Should you, shouldn't you? What's your experience been? And like I said, I'll tell you a quick story. So tonight, was the opening night for my son Nicholas's 7th grade volleyball team's home opener, and they were so excited. And I'm coaching his 7th grade team, and this is the first sport his junior high has been able to field or just, field any kind of sports for the last year. It has been that long since his school has had any kind of organized sports teams. And tonight was their home opener. It was a double header, so it's double the fun, double the excitement, double the nerves. And I will be honest, I had a great time coaching these young men tonight, and they're so much fun, and they have such a great attitude that they make my job easy. And like I said, this was their home opener tonight, and I absolutely love watching them play just for the sheer joy and the fun and the excitement on their faces. And just the fact that they were celebrating every little point and every victory and just cheering each other on. I mean, like I said, just to give you a little background on these kids, these are 7th graders who haven't had any school organized school sports for over a year. I mean, granted, I'm sure some were able to participate in some of the non-school organized sports like clubs and things like that. But being able to play a sport with their friends from school, is something that we all take for granted, right? And like I said, since March 16th, which was yesterday of 2020, these guys haven't had any school sports. It's been shut down. And we weren't even sure that we were going to have a season. So tonight, I can't tell you how much excitement and joy that I could see on their faces and that I was enjoying on my end, just watching them work hard and stay positive with each other and celebrate every point. And they celebrate it with enthusiasm and, you know, whether they were winning or losing. And those guys ended up winning both matches, the second one being a very hard-fought, come-from-behind, thrilling win. You know, it was a team that was overpowering them at first, and then they fought back and kept fighting back. And they just kept celebrating and loving the game and having and celebrating, as they put it, because we have a season, coach. We didn't get to have one last year. We didn't know if we'd have one at all. So we're celebrating that too. And, you know, these guys are amazing. You know, every year when I'm coaching, my players end up teaching me a ton of new lessons and blessings and things to be grateful for. You know, and what I learned out of that is that gentle reminder that even though many, many things have been taken away from us, that have been ended or canceled or postponed, that we still need to take every opportunity to celebrate, you know, the things that we do have and enjoy all of those moments. And I know that's the opposite of what we hear in the media and, you know, what we see on Facebook and what we hear a lot of, but I think we need to be reminded of that, that we need to celebrate the positive things, the small victories, to be grateful for those blessings that we do have. Very strong reminder. So if you heard something that resonated with you, leave me a little love. Answer the question in the thread. Drop your thoughts there if you like. Or even if you're just popping in to say, hey, love the headgear. Share the video with anyone you think it might help. And PM me if you have questions or just want to hear a little bit more. I'm always happy to share the things that I've learned. And PM me if you'd like to hear more about how to stay positive and celebrate the small victories, the small blessings. So tonight, I'm feeling grateful and blessed. Hey friends, I see a whole bunch joining and I missed you again. I apologize, but welcome. I'm glad that you could pop in for a little bit of Wacky Wednesday fun. Happy St. Patrick's Day. Top of the evening to ya. Maybe I should not even try the accent. Nah. But tonight I'm feeling grateful and blessed that I have the chance to coach this amazing and really fun group of seventh graders. And you can hear that my voice is even a little bit scratchy because, hey, I was having a blast watching these guys enjoy the game of volleyball and cheering them on without spectators in the stands and cheering them on as much as possible. And, you know, my seventh graders, they were just finding the joy and the fun in simply the simple opportunity just to have a volleyball season, just to play on a team with their classmates, just to have the chance to play the sport of volleyball, which I happen to love. And they were celebrating every moment, every point, every high, even the mistakes. You know, just the simple opportunity to step on the court, to hang out with their friends and play a team sport. You know, I think we all need to celebrate those small victories, those small blessings, as well as the large ones. And even if it's just something as simple as a junior high volleyball season. I'll catch you later.